many commercial businesses and contractors, a full-size cargo van is a great workhorse to get the job done. But of all the cargo vans on the market, the 2017 GMC Savannah is perhaps the least desirable in our opinion. Like its Chevy relative, the Express, the Savannah does offer plenty of towing capacity thanks to its stout V8 engines. But otherwise the Savannah lags behind rival vans. The Savannah's cargo area is small, and GMC doesn't offer different roof heights for even more room. Its stated design also results in subpar maneuverability and feature availability. There's simply no compelling reason to choose the 2017 GMC Savannah over its rivals. What's new? The optional diesel V8 has been replaced by a four-cylinder diesel. The compressed natural gas, CNG, conversion is no longer available. Otherwise, the Savannah cargo carries forward unchanged. The Savannah cargo is only available in the work van trim level, so your starting configuration will be limited to engine, load and wheelbase choice. Unless you absolutely need the extra payload capacity, starting with the 2500 to keep costs down, though it's worth upgrading to the extended wheelbase version to make up for the Savannah's comparatively small cargo area. The diesel engine will likewise keep the Savannah competitive with fuel-sipping rivals. Trim levels and features: the 2017 GMC Savannah Cargo is a full-size van with an expansive, boxy cargo area behind two front seats. Its Savannah passenger sibling fills this space with additional rows of seating. It's available in two loads: 2,500, max payload 3,234 pounds, and 3,500, max payload 4,192 pounds. Each can be ordered in a standard or extended wheelbase, which increases cargo volume from 239.7 cubic feet to 284.4 cubic feet. Regardless of starting configuration, the Savannah only comes in the modestly equipped work van trim level. A few packages and numerous standalone options are available. By default, the rear-wheel drive Savannah Cargo is powered by a 4.8-liter V8, 285 horsepower, 295 pound-feet of torque, paired to a 6-speed automatic transmission. Alternate powertrains are available if the standard V8 doesn't meet your requirements, including a 6.0-liter V8, 342 horsepower, 373 pounds to feet, matched to a 6-speed automatic and a 2.8-liter diesel 4-cylinder engine, 181 horsepower, 369 pounds to feet, with an 8-speed auto. The work van's standard features include 16-inch steel wheels, 60-40 split opening doors on the right side, a driver information display, air conditioning, power windows and locks, vinyl upholstery and floor covering, LED cargo lighting, 6 steering cargo tie downs, a 120-volt outlet, and a 2-speaker audio system with AM/FM radio and an auxiliary jack. Major equipment packages include the convenience, tilt-adjustable steering wheel and cruise control, chrome appearance, chrome bumpers and grille, hotel shuttle, chrome appearance plus the 6.0-liter V8, a sliding rear passenger door, heated power mirrors, a second row of seating, tinted glass and rear cargo windows, an ambulance, 6.0-liter V8, a heavy-duty locking differential and a more powerful battery and alternator, packages. A separate bundle adds a 6.5-inch touchscreen, navigation, Bluetooth, a CD player and a USB port. Some of the above features can be added as standalone options. Other options include all-terrain tires, remote locking and unlocking, remote engine start, rear parking sensors, a backup alarm, a leather-wrapped steering wheel, cloth upholstery, power-adjustable front seats, a rear-view camera, a 4G LTE Wi-Fi hotspot, GM's OnStar emergency communications, satellite radio, a spray-in cargo liner, and rear air conditioning and heating. TrimTested has not yet driven any version of this vehicle. The following is our first take on what's significant about it and what you can expect. Interior: as in other cargo vans, the Savannah's interior makes liberal use of hard plastics. The engine protrudes into the front footwells, a characteristic of old-school vans that rivals have long since abolished. A low roof and no door behind the driver make it difficult to enter and move around the back. Utility: the cargo area measures 239.7 cubic feet in the short wheelbase Savannah, a few cubes smaller than the class average. This expands to 284.4 cubic feet in the long wheelbase version. Competitors offer much more storage room because they can be ordered with even longer cargo floors and high roofs. Technology: the Savannah fails to impress on the tech front, with just a two-speaker stereo with AM/FM radio and an auxiliary jack listed as standard equipment. Optional extras include a CD player, satellite radio and a touchscreen interface that's older than what you'll find in newer GMC vehicles.